Hey guys, and welcome back to Z3 Cubing. Today I'm going to show you the layer by layer method on the Pyraminx. So this is my tutorial for the layer by layer method on the Pyraminx. This is a very easy method that a lot of beginners use to solve this puzzle, and so I'm going to be aiming this video towards people who have never solved a Pyraminx before. It's definitely not necessarily the easiest way to solve a Pyraminx. There are easier ways that you can learn, but I would recommend if you are a beginner to learn this method because it'll allow you to get pretty fast. You can get down to close to 5 seconds using this method, and it will allow you to expand very easily to even faster methods like L4E in the future. So basically the way that this method works, much like it sounds, is that you solve one layer at a time until the Pyraminx is solved. And so you'll start off making the first layer in two different steps. This is the first step, you solve some of the pieces, and then the second step is you solve the rest of the pieces, kind of like this. Now we have one layer complete, and from here you have to do one of a few different algorithms. And so basically an algorithm is a sequence of moves that you do to finish off the puzzle. And so in this case we would do this algorithm, and that will solve the other layer, and now the Pyraminx is solved. Now when it comes to algorithms, for example this one, instead of just trying to remember exactly what moves I did in what order on the cube, we have a very useful thing called notation, which basically translates that algorithm, that sequence of moves, into a sequence of letters that you can memorize instead. And so before we get on with actually learning how to solve the puzzle, I'm going to very quickly teach you basic notation on the Pyraminx. And so basically anytime you're holding the Pyraminx waiting to do an algorithm, you're always going to want to hold it so that one side is facing you. Not like this or like this, just one side facing right towards you. And basically now, each side of the cube has a letter. And so this top side right here, this is the upside, so its letter is U. This is the right side, so its letter is R. This is the left side, so its letter is L. And you don't actually need to know this, but this is the back side, so its letter is B. Now for each side of the cube, we actually have two different options for how we can turn it. We can turn it like this, clockwise, or like this, counterclockwise. And so if you remember, this side right here is the upside, or U. And so if you just see the letter U by itself, that means turn it clockwise, like this. And now if you see the letter with a little dash next to it, like this, that means turn it counterclockwise. So for example, if you were to see the letters L, R prime, L prime, R, you'd have to go through each of those one at a time, figure out which side is talking about, and figure out which way to turn it. And so starting off with the L, you would go to the left side right here and turn it clockwise. Next we'd go to R prime, so you'd go to the right side, turn that counterclockwise. Next L prime, go over back to the left side, turn that counterclockwise. And now finally to the right side, turn that clockwise. All right, so now that we got basic notation out of the way, I'm going to very quickly just talk about what each piece of the puzzle is called. And so first off, this piece right here is called an edge piece. It has two colors and there's six of them around the cube. It's the primary type of piece that you're gonna have to be focused at moving around the puzzle. Next up, right next to each edge piece, we have two center pieces. And so if you look at it kind of head on like this, we can see that it has three colors. 1, 2, and 3, and there's actually 4 of them around the cube. And then finally, connected to each of these centerpieces, we have one tip piece. So you may have noticed that these tips turn completely independently of all other pieces, and so that makes them basically useless. Solving them doesn't take any thought, you just look at what direction they need to go relative to the center, and solve it. And with that, let's scramble this puzzle up and begin to learn how to solve it. So if you remember, the first step that I showed you in the layer by layer method is just to solve part of the first layer. And the part of it that we're gonna be solving is actually just the centerpieces. So 1, 2, 3 centerpieces right here. We have to make these all the same color so that we can begin solving the layer. So for the sake of example, we're gonna be starting with the color yellow. So to start off, we need to look around the puzzle to find a centerpiece that has the color yellow on it. So let's start off with this centerpiece right here. This one has red, blue, and green on it. This one does not have yellow, so it's not going to be useful to us. Let's move on to another one. How about this one right here? This one has red, green, and yellow. So this one does have yellow, so it is useful to us. Now we need to find the other two centerpieces that also have yellow on them. So we look over here. This one right here has yellow, yellow, blue, and red. And this one up here also has yellow. It has yellow, blue, and green. And so now we know that the three centerpieces that have yellow on them are right here, and right here. You can see yellow, yellow, and yellow. And so that means since they're all kind of converging on this side, we know that this side is going to be the yellow side. It's not going to be this side because there's no yellow center down here. This one, and this one all converge onto this side. And basically all we have to do is move them up to be onto the same side. So now we have yellow, yellow, and yellow all matching. And there we go, we're actually done with the first step. We have all three yellow centerpieces onto the same side. Now before moving on to the next step, we will also want to solve the tips on this one side. So basically all we have to do is turn yellow up so that it's on top. So find the yellow, move it to the top. Find the yellow, move it to the top. And there we go, now we have the first step complete. Let's just do one more quick little example in case I lost you somewhere. Again, we're starting with a scrambled cube. Our goal is to get three yellow centerpieces onto the same side. Let's take a look at one centerpiece to start off with. This one has blue, red, and yellow. So it does have yellow, so it is going to be useful to us. Let's take a look at another centerpiece. This one has red, blue, and green. There's no yellow on it, so we don't care about this one. Moving on to another centerpiece, this one has red, green, and yellow. So it does have yellow. We do like that one. And finally, the last centerpiece we can check, this one also does have yellow. So now our three yellow centerpieces are this one, and this one. So they all converge onto this side. So that means this right here is going to be the yellow side because it has the three centerpieces that have yellow on them. And we'll take each of these centerpieces and move yellow up to the top. So yellow, yellow, and then back in the back here we have also yellow. And again, we can solve the tips, so just move yellow up to the top, yellow up to the top, and yellow up to the top. And now we have our first step, once again, complete. So now that we've solved part of this first yellow layer, the next step is to finish the layer off by putting each yellow edge piece in its correct spot. For example, in between these two yellow centers we just solved, we have to insert the yellow and blue edge piece. In total, to finish off the layer, we'll need to solve three of these yellow edges. So from now on in the solve, we actually don't need to look at the yellow side anymore, so it's easiest if we just put it on the bottom and hold the cube like this for the rest of the solve. Now the three edge pieces we have to solve now are right here, and right here, and they're all going to have yellow on them. And so basically what we want to do is look at the top edge pieces up here, and find one that also has yellow on it. So this one doesn't have yellow on it, but this one does. So this one has yellow and it has red on it. So basically what we want to do is find where on the first layer the yellow and red edge piece needs to go. Now, of course, it's not going to go right here because this slot requires yellow and green. It's also not going to go right here because this slot requires yellow and blue. But it is going to go right here. Yellow and red matches with yellow and red. Now, once we know where it needs to go, we want to take a look at the color that's in the front. So in this case, red. And what we want to do is we want to match up this edge piece on top with that red. So just like this. So red on the edge piece matches red on the front here. This would be incorrect because yellow does not match red. Now what you want to do is take a look at which side of the puzzle this edge piece is on, left or right. In this case, of course, it's over to the left, and so that means we're going to start off solving the piece by turning the right side. So if it's on the left, you start with the right. So what you want to do is bring the right side upwards. Keep in mind that this was the spot that you want the edge piece to go, yellow and red. So you bring the right side upwards, you move the edge piece into the spot where you want it to go, and then you move the right side back downwards. And you can see, now we've solved that edge piece. Now moving on, we want to take a look back at the top layer to find another edge piece that also has yellow on it. So this one does not have yellow on it. Move it over. This one doesn't have yellow, but this one does have yellow. It has yellow and green. And so looking around the cube, it obviously doesn't go in this slot, but it does go in this slot, yellow and green. So now we'll take a look at the color in the front, green, and we'll match up green on this edge piece with the green in the front. Again, this would be incorrect because yellow does not match up green. So green with green, and now since the edge piece is on the right side, we now start with the left side. So we now move the left side up. This is the slot where we want it to go. Now we move the edge piece into the slot where we want it to go. And then we move the left side back down. And there we go, we have now inserted the yellow and green edge piece. All right, so we've now solved two of the three edge pieces. Let's take a look back at the top again to find the last one to insert. This one does not have yellow on it, but this one does. That means it's going to be the one that we need to insert. It doesn't go here, obviously. We already inserted one there. Doesn't go there, but it does go here. So we have yellow and blue matching with yellow and blue. So what we want to do is match up this color with the color on the front, so blue matches blue. The edge piece is on the left, so we move the right up to begin with. This is the slot it needs to go into, move it into the slot, and back down. And so once you've solved three yellow edge pieces, that means you're now done with the entire first layer. And so now you can move on to the last step, which is solving the last layer. If you remember, this can be done all with one algorithm, and then the puzzle will be solved. First though, let's just start over at the beginning of this step with no edges solved, so I can show you a couple more examples. So we always want to start off by looking at the top layer for an edge piece that has yellow on it. This one doesn't, and this one doesn't. So that's a little bit weird. We can't find an edge piece to go in the bottom layer, and that's because they're actually all in the bottom layer. They're just all in the wrong spots. So for example, there's a yellow edge in the bottom right here. It's just not in the right spot. We have green where we should have red. And so all we have to do to get this edge piece out is insert another edge into the spot. It doesn't matter what edge we put in to replace it, just an edge that we don't care about yet. So let's just put in this one right here. So we put it off to the side on the left, we move up to the right side, put it into the slot, and back down. And now if we look at the top layer here, we now do have an edge that has yellow on it. And so all we have to do is find the yellow and green spot, goes right here, yellow and green. We match up green in the front with green on the edge piece. Since it's on the left side, we move the right side up, over and in. Now we can move on to the next piece, so looking for yellow. Yellow, there it is. So we have yellow and red. We look for the yellow and red slot. It is right here. So we match up the front color right here, red, with red on the edge piece that we're inserting. Since it's on the right, we'll start off by moving the opposite left side upwards. We move it over into the correct slot, and we move that side back down. There we go. We now have two of the three edges solved. Finally, for the last one, when we look at the top, no yellow there. No yellow there, and still no yellow there. And as you can see, the problem is that we have the edge piece in its slot, it's just flipped the wrong way around. So we'll handle this annoying case in exactly the same way. We find an edge piece up on the top that we don't care about. How about this one? We insert it into this slot right here by moving the opposite side up, moving it over, and back down. Now if we look at the top layer edge pieces, we can find the yellow one that we want to insert. So we take a look at the front color right here, it's yellow. Match up yellow with yellow. Since it's on the left, we move up the right, move it over into the slot, back down, and we now have the entire layer complete. And we can move on to the last step, which is the last layer. And so the first thing you want to do when moving on to the last layer is just solve the tip, and then you also want to solve the centerpiece. So as you can see, we have red right here and blue right here. So you just want to move it over until it's solved, so red and red. One more time, once you finish the first two steps and the first yellow layer, what you want to do is take a look up top, solve the tip by just matching up the colors like this, and then you also want to solve the centerpiece. So right here we have green, match that up with green. Now we can take a look at the remaining edge pieces and decide what algorithm we want to do to solve the cube. Now the first case you can get is actually this one right here. Now this one's actually very easy to recognize because once you have the tip and the centerpiece lined up like this, every single piece on the puzzle will be solved except for these two. And they'll actually both be in the correct spot, just flipped around incorrectly. So if you get this case, you're gonna hold the two flipped edge pieces in the front, just like this, and then you're gonna execute your very first algorithm. So this algorithm goes L, R prime, L prime, R, U prime, R, U, R prime. Now this algorithm is actually very easy to remember because you can pretty much just think of it as holding the cube like this, starting off the left side, going down, down, up, up, and then shifting your left hand up to the top, and then starting with that side, going up, up, down, down. Alright, so let's say we've just solved the first layer, and moving on to the last layer, we see this. So first off, of course, we have to solve the tip, just match up the colors, and of course also solve the centerpiece, match it up with the color on the bottom, and now we see this. We have three edge pieces in the wrong spots, but we also have these kind of cool looking matching pairs of colors on each side. So you want to hold the puzzle so that you're only looking at one face, like this. You want to look at the main color on this face, so red of course, and then you look at the other two sides to see where the other two red edge pieces are. So these two edges on the right aren't red, but these two on the left are. Now because we see the front color red to the left, we now do this algorithm. R, U, R prime, U, R, U, R prime. So let's say that we have the same case, red is still the main color on the front, but taking a look at the left here, we no longer have those two red edge pieces. Instead, we have to look over to the right. So if that front color red is over to the right, we now do R, U prime, U prime, R, U prime, R prime. Now those two cases look almost identical, and the algorithms are very similar too. They both involved turning the right side upwards, doing some U move, turning the right side back down, doing the same U move, right side up, U move, right side down, U move. The only thing that's different is the U move, whether it's going clockwise or counterclockwise. So basically all that you have to remember is that if the front color, red, is moving off to the left here, that means that you have to do clockwise U moves. If instead it's moving off to the right here, then you have to do counterclockwise U prime moves. In this case though, red is moving off to the left, so we just have to remember clockwise U moves. So we turn the right side up, and then do clockwise U, down, clockwise U, up, clockwise U, and down. Finally, if you finish your first two steps and your first layer here, moving on to your last layer, you solve the tip, you solve the center, and you have three unsolved edges that don't appear to follow any sort of pattern, then you have one of the two annoying cases. Now, if you take a look at, say, this edge piece, you'll notice that even though it's definitely not solved, one of the colors is still kind of lined up correctly, so red on the edge piece is lined up with red all around it. It's definitely not in the right place, but it's kind of half solved. Now, if you take a look at this edge piece, it's also kind of half solved because this green's in the right spot, and if you take a look at this edge piece, it's actually not solved at all. Neither of these colors are lined up with the pieces around them. So if you get a case like this, there will always be two edges that are kind of half right, this one and this one, and then the other edge will be totally wrong. And so you want to take that edge that is totally wrong and put it in the back like this. So now you want to take a look at just the front face. You'll notice that the edge on one of the two sides will look kind of like it's solved. So in this case, on the right side here, it looks like it's kind of solved, even though it's definitely not. So if it is on the right like this, what you want to do is L, U, R, U prime, R prime, L prime. If instead you come across this case, you find the edge that is totally unsolved, put that in the back like this, and now looking at the front face alone, it looks like the left side is solved instead of the right side. If it is on the left, now you do R prime, U prime, L prime, U, L, R. So there's really no easy way to remember those two algorithms. You just gotta memorize them, put the totally wrong piece in the back, and then if it looks like the left side is solved, you do the algorithm starting with the right move. And if it looks like the right side is solved, like it is right now, you do the algorithm starting with the right move. Anyway, that is the layer by layer method on the Pyraminx. I know this video is definitely getting a bit long. I just wanted to go through every single step in this tutorial in a lot of detail so that you guys don't get stuck. If you do get stuck though, be sure and leave your problem down in the comments below and I'll try and get back to you. Anyway, that is pretty much it for this video. I hope you learned something and I'll see you guys next time.